Kingfisher.
I find that very interesting, tourism. You can be your own boss, let's put it that way. You get to meet a lot of different people, and you just be yourself. Be proud of who you are, and your culture, you know, and your traditions. You have it all there. But you still need to have some kind of an education.
As entrepreneurs and wanting to get into tourism, they have to see how the operation works.
We're trying to start a tourism tour back home too, and I thought this would give me a lot of ideas.
This would be officially day one of the tour. Yes, we've had challenges. We got here later than expected. We had to stop in another location to have meals for 18 of us. Now we're here and we'll see what today brings us. But yeah, the best practices is not just always how things are great, but it's also the challenges the participants are actually going to go through, and they're going to evaluate what they liked, what they do differently, and how they can apply it to their own businesses.
It's a learning experience. Well, I always wanted to go on a tour, never had the chance. You know.
2 eggs, bacon.
You start by that. And then you got the toast, and this is for your dessert. Uh-huh. And mind you, we're deeply in the bush, eh? It's amazing.
He doesn't have a five-star or multi-million dollar complex with the pool and the slides out there, but instead what he has is his experience and his passion for what he's doing. He's being a keeper of the land, and also an ambassador to his culture. And that's wonderful. And as tourism is going now, and ecotourism specifically, that is what people are really looking for, is experiential. Keep in mind, the experience is how it makes you feel. Because that truly is what tourism comes down to if you're doing it successfully, if you can make people feel good.
Make sure that they have everything, and that everything goes right. You guys are in the smoke and you're really going to get cooked over there. If you want to move over to the sides there. I was very lucky also in my business here. I had my wife help me, you know. She was the cook and I was working on the grounds.
Everything has to be spick and span all over. You don't have any papers laying around the ground, and make sure that your campsite looks good.
The only things I really needed was a place to eat. Tents and stoves and all that, you know, mattresses, and a good sleeping bag for the winter time, of course. And in the summertime, well, I use these little ones.
But in the winter time, I have to use the good ones, you know, the minus 30, 35. If you're going to move around, it's better with snowshoes, I will say, because in my point of view, when you're walking through the forest or through the trails that you're walking, you have time to look inside, you know, and you see the fresh tracks of a rabbit or the lynx or the fisher or the marten that pass there. When you're going through a skidoo, with a skidoo, you're going too fast, and the people don't see that. I don't know what to show you. You know everything about the bush life. We'll go to my little shed back over there. The beaver uses this gland to spread his smell around his environment. But us, we use it as medicine. If you want to get rid of a cold, add it on in your tea. And it's a very, very good, you know, for the this respiratory system. But bring the people here, and I explain to them how to tie a hive. This is how I work. I'll do it just like as if you guys are tourists and you don't know nothing about this. So these are the bones that I bring out, you know, the caribou bone and this one here. And I bring out my michkun. And the other one, the pushkategan. So these are the things, you know, that I show the people. And I will scrape it like that. It's a must for us to continue these traditions and always respect the animals that we killed by hanging up the bones on a tree. And that's our way of treating the wildlife that we have here in respect, so that there will always be an abundance.
You may write your answers in Cree, French, or English, and it shouldn't take you very long. But I think, as you mentioned, Michel, he answered all of our questions. He also looked at a model, I think, which works very well for ecotourism. Grow as you go. You can start with a small idea and a family idea.
At Gordon Moore's camp, I thought that was really interesting. I always knew like it could be done. It's simple. If you have the land base and if you have elders, everything that you need is right there. To promote the culture, the traditions.
Take care, all you guys. Don't make me cry now.
People were friendly, and you felt at home.
We are just beside the Saguenay Fjord. This is a very important, very interesting model of business, because every part of the cooperative is specialized, and everyone is very specific in their operations. So in the marketing, in the operation too, it helps to split the costs. And members are the owner of the cooperative. So it's a really good feeling also. The co-op is operating sea kayaking, rope course, sailing, and the Via Ferrata. We have a mini one. This is a wall course. You follow away on the walls with the beautiful view in the fjord, and this is an activity mostly done in Europe.
Hello.
Hi.
My name is Jerome. I am the manager of the place. Wow. Welcome to the park.
We're gonna have a walk around here to see the installation and everything. That's all right with you?
Yes, we need to walk.
The hikes, you don't have to be all that long. That could be very easily done in Yoshi.
Maximum 5.
And for the tree houses, that can be made available. Like, our trees are not all that tall, but it's not impossible, I'd say.
Every 2 years, it's good to create new activities. And with the co-op, it is more easy. Two. When you love nature, this is a natural way to go in that kind of business.
Yeah, the co-op, the community level, but I think that would be the best way to go.
Today, we have a really, really, really a cool day planned, and hopefully we're going to see some whales.
All the restaurants
are closed
right now. We're here.
We have a choice. So, who would like to go on the hike? Say yes. Who would like to look at the interpretive center? Say yes. Hike?
Hike?
Yeah. Is there anybody that has a problem with walking 3 kilometers in and 3 kilometers out?
Me.
It's too short. Sherman will carry you, don't worry.
It's too short.
Don't go off the trail. So for preservation, we don't want to step on and hurt the forest, right?
Yes, exactly. Okay. I don't need to talk. Yeah.
I thought it was an interesting walk, a hike. It was on a historical trail, and we do have a lot of those.
We're on the St. Margaret River, which is about 25 kilometers from Tadoussac. And it's part of the Fjord Saguenay. It is one of the main attractions in Quebec because of the beluga whales coming up here, and a lot of birds migrate through here too. And then also it's one of the main waterways of Quebec.
When we did that trail and we were looking at the plaques, the historical significance of the place, that we can do as well. We do have a lot of history, a lot of stories. It doesn't really take much. We just need to cut a trail. Maybe not necessarily boardwalks, resting places for sure. And we do have high ground. We could actually have an observatory. At a different time of day, the animals will come out.
Wait, you gotta go. And on the back, we gotta say, ah!
Okay.
Cheers!
Ça, c'est notre spécialité, c'est des baleines bleues. Des fois, c'est simple. Le matin, ça n'a pas pris de temps. Ils ont trouvé une tout de suite, mais après-midi, là, j'en ai pas vu, mais peut-être qu'on va les voir sur l'eau.
Flotation devices, we hardly ever use those. And I think now that we got to have those if we're going to take people out, you know, the safety aspect to it.
They have a Honda 200 horsepower.
That's a nice one.
We got greeted by the operator, but nobody was there to tell us where we're going, how long we're going, until we got into the boat.
We went out in 2 boats whale watching. And the one group actually got an amazing experience because they were educated, but in the other boat, the participants didn't have the interpretation, they didn't have the interaction with the guide.
Ici, il y a peut-être un peu trop de glace pour eux autres. Okay. Mais ils sont bien équipés pour la glace parce que, je ne sais pas si tu as remarqué, sur le dos, il n'y a pas d'aileron.
Oh.
Ils ont une crête dorsale. Okay. Avec ça, ils arrivent à casser la glace.
La key, you could hear them.
Avant ça, on faisait ça du début mai, du 1er mai au 30 octobre. Mais je faisais ça toute seule, j'avais pas d'employés, tout ça. On avait juste un bateau. Il y avait pas de frais, ou presque pas. Mais là, quand on a eu 2 bateaux, là, on n'en fait plus dans le mois de mai. Ça coûte trop cher, puis il y a pas beaucoup de monde.
The captain of our boat was very informative. And we had a lot of questions as well. So. He answered most of the questions.
Our guy didn't say much. We didn't really get the full value, I guess. Not like the other group. We did see whales, but a bit more explanation. We could have learned a bit more.
And we actually sat in the water for 45 minutes waiting for a blue whale to come up. It was a great opportunity to share with us, but the guy didn't. And the other group came back raving about their experience, and just goes to show you, it's the people that make the product, really.
The lodging, I thought, was interesting, yeah? The different types of lodging that we stayed in. Like a bed and breakfast was more personal. We got to meet the people that run the place, you know? I thought it was something that would work up north.
Field berry juice that has cranberry juice.
Well, I just wanted to let you guys know, enjoy your breakfast, and we'll probably meet somewhere around 9 o'clock.
Okay, there's a shower there. Shower.
My name is Pierre Gaudreau. I am the general manager of Aventure Ecotourisme Québec. So this morning we will talk about the adventure and the ecotourism product in all Quebec territory, okay? So the mission is protect, represent and promote the interests of Quebec professional adventure and tourism ecotourism outfitters. 20% of the producer are ecotourism, okay? Like Marimonde is an ecotourism product. They have some directive for the tourists to protect all the environment. In ecotourism, it's really important to work with the local community. To develop a real partnership, a business partnership, you need to maximize your impact economic in the region. That's the way the ecotourism is developed. The association, it's around 135 outfitters members. We got three kind of product, soft adventure, like a little hike with interpretation, more risky adventure product, like a canoeing in the big river, and we got the ecotourism product. We develop an accreditation program with 60 norms. They need to have evacuation plans. The guide needs to have lots of competence and experience to be a guide, okay? They have to assume the leadership during the expedition. They need to assume the security of the participant. They need to put the emergency procedure during the expedition. They need to manage the dynamic of the group. They need to verify all the equipment. You will see that with Pierre. When you you receive some tourists, you need to clarify the physical condition the participant need to have for do this expedition. When you implant a lot of safety guidelines, so you minimize the risk, so you minimize the lawsuit, and so you can have a competitive liability insurance.